Hey YouTubers, for those of you who follow me on a regular, welcome back. For those of you who are new, welcome to my channel. Please do excuse my voice. I just got back from vacation for 7 days, and of course I was yelling and hollering and having all sorts of fun. So I'm not sick, I just have a sore throat. So I got my Universal Yum Box when I got back. It is from Greece this month. I'm very excited to try some of these things. I've got some awesome sweets in here, guys. There's something in here that is... Oh, man. Okay. Let me just go ahead and get started. I want to make this video quicker than it usually is for me because I do take a time to chat. I'm a gabby person. Okay. So, let's start with the pesto basil chips, guys. I'm not exactly sure how you pronounce this, but it's telling me that the word basil means royal plant. So I'm gonna pop these open. If you guys can see, those are like little nuggets. Let's see if I can block my face out of here. There you go. So I'm gonna give these a try. It tastes like spaghetti. I'm not even kidding. It literally tastes like spaghetti with garlic bread. All at the same time. These things are delicious. Okay. Clean my palate. The next thing I'm going to be trying is Tatis oregano chips. I'm really excited about this pack. I'm going to be honest with you guys, as far as like the hard candies, I've already tried them. I couldn't wait. It smells pretty good. That's what they look like. I hope you guys can hear me. Wow. These are some serious chips, guys. This is way bigger than what we would normally get in our bags. We would probably get something about like right here in America. Okay. They do taste like oregano. They're a very firm chip. Very crunchy. They're not greasy or thin like most of the chips here. They got good chips. Okay. So the next thing. This is the last bag of chips, you guys. They're called bruschettini pizza. It's cheese, tomato, and basil pizza. I'm interested to try this because I like pizza. It's like little crackers. You guys see that? Little bread crackers. Oh, it actually is. It's legitimately like I'm having such a loss for words today, you guys. Crouton. I'm not really tasting a pizza at all. It tastes like a breadstick dipped in like tomato juice. Not one of my favorites. But it's not bad. Now I'm going to move on to my favorite part. The Lickies and Chewies. I love sugar, you guys. Like, I'm hypoglycemic. So my body doesn't make a whole lot of insulin. So the fact that I can enjoy this kind of stuff is an enjoyment to me. Yay. Okay. So the first thing I have is an Oriental Sargli. It's a Greek baklava. Say in this version, this version takes the elements of an original baklava. It's a flaky dough, buttery syrup, almonds, and walnuts, and puts them into an oh-so-cute roll, creating the perfect party treat. I really like baklava. I've only had it a couple times, but I really liked it. So I'm excited to give it a try because I don't remember where it was that I tried it. Was I here? Maybe it was someone that I knew that gave it to me. I don't know. I've tried it before. Okay, so, it's so cute. Oh my gosh, so when you open it, it comes in this cute little plastic thing right here. I like that. I don't know why they don't do that here in our country, where every single thing is in its own little individual pack. I think this is adorable. Oh, guys, look how cute that is. It's the size of like a little lady finger, you know? I'm gonna pop one out and give it a try. Oh, it's flaky. Oh, guys, just look. I can't not. That flaky crust is so good. I just want you guys to look at how moist that is. That is moist. That is moist. Wow, this is nice. I'm gonna catch that when it falls. Don't worry, guys. It's really nice looking. I can't show it anymore. I gotta take a bite. I feel like I should take a pray. Oh my god, I can't even talk. I feel like I should pray over this. That is amazing. That's amazing. Okay. My stomach is doing all sorts of happy things right now. I'm gonna eat this as soon as I get off of this video. I gotta lick my fingers. I don't even wanna rinse my mouth out because it'll take away the goodiness. Goodness. Sorry. Okay, the next thing is a Serenata finger. It is a milk chocolate coated wafer. Let me turn it sideways so you guys can see it. Milk chocolate coated wafer with cocoa cream filling. Okay, so I'm gonna be honest. I don't like wafers. Only because I ate so many of them one time. In a period of 2 months, I gained almost 30 pounds. I was very depressed back then, so I don't eat like that now, clearly, so. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Oh, look, it's got a cute little, like, chocolate stripe on it. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Okay. You know, this is one wafer I would probably eat. It would probably get me in trouble, but I would eat it. So, now going on to the next page. Guys, I'm so sorry for my voice. it's a Dogoyaro soft wheat cookie with grape must flavor. When I opened the bag and I saw this, I thought, you know what? How clever is that? That they make a soft wheat cookie and put grape in it. I mean, that's a great idea. Guys, and look, this stuff only has 180 calories. Okay, here's some of the ingredients, you guys. In case you're wondering if you might be allergic to some stuff, I am noticing that they are putting calories on the back of the packages now. To let you know what you're eating if the package doesn't say so, which I really appreciate because I was wondering what I was eating a couple times. Oh, I just ripped the package by accident. But here it is. It's just your basic, like, wheat-looking cookie. It smells like an oatmeal raisin cookie. But that's strange because it's supposed to be a grape cookie. Okay. I know this flavor. This is very dry. Guys, give me 1 second. It's like glue now. It's sticking to my mouth. I gotta pause the video and go get more water. This is not going anywhere. Okay, I'm back, guys. So, this soft wheat cookie with grape must flavor tastes exactly like spice cake. You know how, like, it's got a spice in there I can't put my finger on, but you find it in spice cake. I don't really taste any grape. It tastes fruity. But it's not actually like a grape. But it's not bad, you guys. It's pretty good. The next thing I'm going to try is this. It's a milk chocolate coated hazelnut topped wafer with cream filling. Okay. Another wafer. Okay. Well, that other one wasn't so bad. So I'm pretty sure this will be pretty good too. Okay. This guy's comes like a candy bar. I think that is pretty cool. It says it's a wafer though. It's described as a mixture of pounded hazelnut and honey, black pepper. Really? Ooh, it smells like hot chocolate and almonds. Oh, it's soft. Wow. Our wafers don't taste that good. This is great. I thought it was going to be crunchy. But it's actually very tolerable. It's very soft. The nuts are just enough crunch to let you know that they're there. The chocolate flavor, very chocolatey. Very dark chocolatey. It tastes like dark hot chocolate. I do taste the cream. It's delicious. My mouth's watering. Good thing I skipped supper, because I think I just found my dinner. And there's nobody here to ask me for some. Okay. The next thing, okay, I guess you're traditional, I guess, is a King Soft cookie with dark chocolate chunks. Soft cocoa cookie, dark chocolate pieces. As most of you guys know, I'm not a dark chocolate fan. And I don't like white chocolate. And I don't like licorice either. And I'll tell you why. I just mentioned that in a second. So, cookie. Ooh, it's super soft. Ooh, gosh. That is some dark chocolate. Ooh, fudgy. Guys, look at that. Like, oh my gosh. It's so soft, I don't even want to drop it. Look at the fudge in it. You could just see the fudge shining. We don't get cookies like that. We have fudge cookies, but they're not fudgy. Can you guys see the glistening in this? I'm ready to try some dark chocolate. Very dark chocolatey. If you like dark chocolate, you're gonna love this. Wow, it's so fudgy. I have to rip the bag to get it back in there. It is so fudgy. Now that I got the bag ripped, I'll go ahead and turn it around. Do you guys see the streaks of fudge in here? Wow, super dark chocolatey. I think it tastes a little bit like a fudge round. Just like the fudge round without the cream. Like, super chocolatey. Wow, it's still all over my fingers. I think I just gained like a pound in my hips. So good. So only got two more things, you guys. The next thing is going to be the Minos Nut Bar. Peanut and honey. Okay, I love nut bars. I love honey bars. Like, this is just so shiny and delicious looking. I'm just ready to tear into this right now, so I'm not gonna talk about it anymore. I'm ripping it apart. Excuse me, you guys. Oh, it's delicious and sticky. It kinda reminds me about like a little nut and a honey bar. It's crunchy. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, it's just enough honey to make it sticky. But they are very good peanuts. They're quality peanuts. Not like what you get in like a Payday. Or like one of your, you know, your little fiber bars and stuff. This is legit. But I love sweets. Like, I'm a sweet freak. So, wasn't sweet enough for me. Okay, last thing. This is humongous, you guys. Like, legitimately humongous. Look at the size. I mean, it looks like it would be good, right? So this is a sourdough with cocoa cream. This is sweetbread with chocolate cream. I'm interested to see what this is going to be like. Okay, I'm trying not to be killing my bag here. Oh, it is. It's like a legitimate roll. Like, you know, it looks kind of like our slider rolls, our dinner roll. It says it has cream in it, so let's see. Oh, didn't get far enough. So the cream's further down. Oh, cream. Okay. It is, ooh, it's nice and gooey, right? Okay. This is not for me. The cream is chocolatey. I'm sorry, you guys, that was really thick. So, for that, the cream in the middle, delicious. Okay, delicious. But the bread tasted sour. I'm not sure. I'm gonna hold this back up again. You guys, if any of you guys are from Greece or know about Greece food and you've tried this, comment down below and let me know, is the bread supposed to have a soury, sweet taste to it? Or not? So, the last thing is the yum bag. And they always give you like little goodies and stuff, little pieces of candy. I, guys, am not a licorice person. And they have these little candies right here. They are licorice. Guys, and this is black licorice. Like, this is one of the kind of licorice that I dislike the most. But just for you guys, I'm going to put it in my mouth. Because I do know what licorice is supposed to taste like. I used to eat it a lot as a little kid. I just don't like it now. So this is what it looks like when you take it out. Okay, it's like a little, it's kind of like one of our little lemon heads or something. Whoa. Wait. I think I might like this. That's not right. That's not right. I don't like black licorice. But I like this candy. I don't even want to get rid. Oh my god. I don't even want to get rid of it. I don't like licorice, you guys. That was delicious. What are your secrets? How do you do that? How do you make something that someone doesn't like to where they actually want to eat it? What is your secret? Okay. Next is the honeycomb candy. So it's a taffy that's honey flavor. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I've already tried one. It tastes like popcorn to me. The honey flavor is only there for a second, and then it turns like toffee, buttery flavor. So I'm just going to pass on eating that because I've already had one, and I'm going to save that last one for my stepson. So I've already tried this piece too, but it's delicious, and I'm just going to have to eat it again. And I also want to open this so you guys can see. It is a jelly candy, pomegranate flavor. Now, if you guys are from the South like I am, it's a good possibility that your grandma or your mama had one of those, like, candy Christmas tree dishes, you know, that it was like a bowl on the bottom, and then the Christmas tree went up, and vines or whatever. Branches. Oh my god, guys, I'm so sorry. I'm licking windows right now. Anyway, you know those little jelly candies that they used to put on there? This is exactly what that is, but it's a lot more flavorful. But I'm going to open this up, guys, because it actually comes in its own little wrapper inside the wrapper, because it is so gooey. Okay, so the wrapper's coming off with it. But this is it, you guys. Like I was saying, you remember the little gummy candies on your grandma's little candy Christmas tree? So, see exactly what that is. But guys, this is so good.
It's so good.
I love pomegranate.
Oh my gosh.
So, well, guys, that is it for the unbox from Greece. I did manage to shave quite a bit of time off than I normally do, because I didn't talk about it too much. But guys, for those of you who have not tried Universal Yums, I originally made a comment that it was an expensive Facebook clickbait. I now retract that comment because I have been so impressed with the quality of service that I have received from customer service, you guys. So here's gonna be my rant. Customer service has been amazing. Every single time I've had an issue or even a question, I don't even have to have an issue. I could just randomly text them, like email them. If I would just want to say, hey, how you doing, Universal Yums? I love your box. They will respond to you within an hour. Every single time I've had an issue, guys, I have never been more satisfied with a company than Universal Yums. I highly recommend these people. Look at the cute little book they send you. Like, it's like trivia questions and stuff like that. Or there's information about where your candies come from in specific. And then there's little trivia questions. Guys, how cute is that? And then they gave me this cute little thing about Greece. Again, where your candies come from. And on the back, it's like the official Yum Award. So you have an option to rate it. Which ones you like the best to the least? Which ones were awkward? Which ones you want to see again? And it's telling you how to play an ancient Greek game. So guys, I'm going to show you the Universal Yum Box for those of you who haven't actually seen it. Well, I'm going to cover this up because it's got my address on it. But the Universal Yum Box, it's so good. So this is the medium box, you guys. And just to kind of give you a good idea of what size it is, I'll give it to me. It's the same size as my chest, but I am only 5'3" and about 115 pounds. So I am kind of a petite person. But, I mean, gosh, guys, you get so many snacks. Plus, you get an extra bag. You get a bonus bag you didn't even pay for. And most of the time they send you an extra piece of something. So when this runs out, because I actually got this for a gift for someone, but they couldn't be here for the video, so I went ahead and tried it for them. It's great, dude. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching my channel. Sorry again about the voice. I know it's going to be really aggravating to you. I've sounded like this for 3 days. I'm annoyed with myself. I keep telling myself to shut up, but I never listen. This mouth gets me in a lot of trouble. Mostly with myself. So, thanks again. You guys, don't forget to support your military, your local police officers, fire departments. Look out for motorcycles, you guys. I've seen some really bad motorcycle accidents on the way up to Georgia. So, right in front of Asheville, there was a motorcycle under an 18-wheeler tire and a person. And it was a little traumatic to see. I love motorcycles. I'm a motorcycle mama. You know, anything a Harley, I'm gonna jump on that. And you know, the funny thing is, like, I love motorcycles so much, I'll even ride a crotch truck. I prefer a Harley because I'm a Harley girl. I love my soft tails, y'all. But anyway, guys, watch out for motorcycles and enjoy your vacation. I will be also posting some videos that don't involve taste testings. There's some things that I feel like I want to share with YouTube. I just went through a divorce. It was very bad. And I want to share my experiences with you guys, and also share with some of the other females, such as myself, military wives, who unfortunately, when the separation begins, there's some things that you're told that aren't exactly true. And I'd like to help other people understand how to get through it, everything like that. So guys, please stay tuned. Watch out for my videos. Like, subscribe. Hit the notification button. And if you can, give me a shout out on YouTube. Also, give me a shout out on Instagram. Look forward to seeing you. See you next month for the next Universal Yum Box. Hey, Universal Yums, great job. Customer service, unfriggin' believable. Unbelievable.